Hello, my name is Ryan. I recently purchased an early 1985 944 that had been sitting in a garage for the past 20 years. I removed the transaxle so I could pull the torque tube back, and then I removed the engine out the top, with plans to clean and reseal it. In this video, I will disassemble the engine down to the short block, removing the accessories, cam assembly, and the cylinder head. Welcome to 944 Restore. I first removed the right engine mount bracket. There are two size bolts, and the longer bolts go in the bottom. Next to go is the oil cooler heat shield. It's mounted using two 10mm bolts. I'm now removing the engine hoist hook on the cam assembly. More 10mm bolts here. I'm now focusing on the balance and drive belts and gears. I'm temporarily putting the crank bolt back on so I can set the engine back to top dead center. Here's the camshaft timing mark. The balance marks are located on the back side of the balance gear, so not visible here, but you can at least see where on the belt cover they should line up with. Now that the engine is at TDC, I'm going to loosen the balance tensioner pulley and remove the balance belt. I'm now removing the balance belt idler pulley. It took a little bit of effort, but I was able to wiggle the crank accessory gear off. I'm now loosening the timing belt tensioner so I can take the timing belt off. The timing idler pulley is the smaller size. I'll be replacing that with the newer 46mm idler along with a new style water pump. A spanner wrench is recommended to remove the balance pulleys. I bought a really inexpensive one from Harbor Freight. It just barely fit into the holes on the other side, and I had a difficult time putting the socket on the bolt. I'll be upgrading to a better wrench for reassembly. I'm now removing the final four bolts holding on the rear timing belt cover. The longer bolts go in the bottom. I was worried about the lifters falling out when I removed the cam assembly, so I rotated the engine. This worked and I had no issues with the lifters. Before removing the cover screws, I made sure to wake them up and hit the end of the socket with a hammer, as recommended in Clark's Garage. I'm going to do the same thing here and wake up the cam cover Allen bolts. I'm removing the bolts in the reverse order of installation, starting with the outside and working my way in. The cam cover is still under pressure from the valve springs, so I'm gradually loosening each bolt until the pressure is relieved. This process takes a while. It's a new day, and I'm starting off by removing the lower balance shaft cover. I need to first remove the woodruff key before this cover is going to come off. I was able to remove the woodruff key by just lightly tapping on it with a hammer and a chisel. Next up is the oil cooler housing. there is a bracket on one of the lower bolts that secures the oil pressure sending unit wire that routes past here. With the housing off, I'm going to remove the oil cooler next. It's held on by some gaskets. I was able to pry it off using just my hands. One thing I forgot to do is to remove the oil pressure relief valve. There's a plug on the oil cover. Here it is circled for reference. There's an alignment tool that goes there, so I'll need to remove that plug before I reinstall the oil cooler. 3 bolts hold on the air oil separator. This is straightforward to remove. And next to go is the left side engine mount. This is the accessory bracket. It's where the AC and the alternator attach to. The bracket connected to this bolt here is where the alternator wires are connected with a clip. I actually have no idea what this bracket is used for, possibly something with the air filter housing or the MAF. This is the other engine lift hook. This is where the upper coolant hose connects to the engine. I'm waking up these bolts before I remove them. I'm removing some of the brackets attached to the engine. You can see from this picture where the wiring harness connects to them. The bolts to the water pump are varying length. I'm going to try and remove the pump with the bolts in their original locations to make reassembly easier. The bracket shown here on the water pump is for the oil pressure sending unit. The wire routes past here. I'm now going to work on pulling the cylinder head. First step is to remove these 2 bolts. I'm just going to lay them back in place. The bolts for the head are torqued really tight. I had to brace the engine with my body while I broke them loose to keep the engine from tipping over. Similar to the cam assembly, I'm working from the outside in reverse order of installation. Well, this is it for part one. Thanks so much for watching. Next, I'm going to disassemble the rest of the engine down to the block. If you'd like to see more, please hit the subscribe button. And if you have any tips or pointers, please leave them in the comments. Thanks.